patrzy, już chodź na...
I'm on 3 on 3. 1, 2, 3, 3 on 4.
Step 3.
Yeah. Yeah. Expectations. Too many. I got too many on the gate. I got too many on the gate. I got too many on the gate. Had to put the effort just to meet my expectations. And you know I want it bad, but I gotta keep my patience. And you know I want it bad, but I gotta keep my patience.
So you guys have made it to the finals of Interclass. How are you feeling today?
You know, surely the nerves are there, you know. But I just told the boys, you know, play it hard. And we'll win. I know these guys have more talent, and I'll accept it. But the reason we made it here is based off heart. We played with heart. And just based off how we beat the Foot Twos on Wednesday, I feel like we can hold these guys up. We can hold these guys up and probably win.
It's a bit tense. I mean, this team is equally good. And they've showed out through their games and whatever they've been doing. But we believe the best player will. Or rather the best team in the world. And yeah, excellence and greatness is a thing that's achieved by hard work. So yeah, we're feeling a big chance, but we know what to do.
Feeling confident that we can win, get the win. We can't underestimate our opponents. They're a hard team. We play as a team, trust in God, we're going to win today.
I'm feeling excited. There's a little pressure. I'm always excited.
What you learned over the period of this interclass with respect to the sport?
Basketball takes a lot of discipline. You can't train, one person can't train the whole game, even as a player as a team. Yeah. So I think I've learned, the main thing I've learned is team.
To enter games with humility. When you enter with the mentality that you're better with the other team, if you have the opportunity to get it with the brain, that can be hard to pick up. For example, in our first game,
compared to the first game, how much do you think you've changed, or what changes do you think you individually and as a team have made?
Individually, I would say the intensity of the game has changed completely. We've been able to, as a team, chemistry has improved a lot. We're able to see each other, know how to play. I mean, we're moving as a team.
So, do you think you're going to win today?
Rather not. The match could go either.
So, what have you guys been doing to ensure that you win today? At least,
play well. Yeah, I mean, keep the right mentality, no arrogance, no fear. This a good midpoint.
Okay, so what are some of the things that you've noted or observed over the games that you've refereed?
Well, first of all, I would say this is the second year we're having this interclass basketball tournament. And I could say compared to 2019, because that's the first time we had it, is that this year around that all games are very tight. So most games have been won and lost within a margin of 10 points. So that's the most surprising, well, most thing I've noted. So the games are very tight. We expected them to be, maybe some games are wider than others, but they are tight.
What are you especially looking forward to seeing in this game?
Well, this game again is a game of favorites versus underdogs. So the underdogs have nothing to lose, the favorites have everything to do with it. So it should be an interesting game from both sides.
A bit of a controversial question. Who do you think is going to win this game?
I cannot give that answer. I'm supposed to be very neutral. So just to, in case I'm quoted as yeah. But we expect a tight game nonetheless.
Yeah. Sasa, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Would you say that you personally find inspiration in your students, especially those who are playing today?
Yes, yes, they play their hearts out. There was determination, there was teamwork. I think it's a demonstration not only of talent, but the importance of the teamwork.
You've watched the entirety of this game. Would you confidently say that the Strathmore spirit was clearly shown on this court today?
Well, suddenly that all may be one, so looking at the students' brain, we're not able to tell what their socio-economic backgrounds are, what their religion is, but for one, they put all their efforts together, all their energies together, and all their minds together to win.
Thank you.
Let's give a big round for Joseph Ngala.